So in today's lecture, we shall discuss about how to write the Verilog code for a code converter. And here we have taken one example of binary to gray code converter, and we will write the behavior model, data flow model, and a structure model of binary to gray code converter. And finally, I will write the test bench and I will show you the simulation results. So now we will discuss about binary to gray code converter. So for this code converter, we will take one example of 3-bit binary, 4-bit. We will take example of 4-bit. Four-bit binary to gray. Code converter. Four-bit binary to gray code converter. So here we have the block diagram will be like this. We have this converter which is having four input lines. And these input lines are from these input lines we will feed the binary inputs. So B3, B2, B1, and B0. These are the 4-bit binary numbers where B3 is the MSB and B0 will be the LSB. And this circuitry will convert this binary number, 4-bit binary number, into its equivalent 4-bit gray code with G3 is the MSB, and after G3, G2, G1, and G0. Here G0 is the LSB bit of gray code. So here we find this truth table. Here B3, B2, B1, B0 are the binary inputs, and G3, G2, G1, G0 is the gray outputs. So since it is a 4-bit binary to gray converter, so in total we are having 16 binary combinations, right? So these are the combination like this: combination number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. These are total 16 binary combinations. Now, what is the algorithm? What is the logic behind the conversion of binary number into gray number? It is like this. Suppose we have 4-bit binary number B3, B2, B1, and B0. Let us take any number. Suppose the number is 0, 0, 1, 1. To convert this binary number into 4-bit gray number, what we should do? MSB bit, we write as it is. Then this B3 bit will be added with B2 bit. Whatever is the result, neglect the carry and write the result here. So here 0 plus 0 is 0. Now this B2 bit, add B2 bit with B1 bit. Neglect the carry and keep the sum bit. So 0 plus 1 is 1. So write 1 here. Then B1 bit will be added with B0 bit. So here 1 plus 1. So if you add 1 with 1, what we will get? 1 plus 1 is 0 and 1 carry will be generated. Right? So neglect this carry. Only keep the sum bit. So sum bit is 0. So write it here. So 0010. If this is a binary number, then the gray number will be gray code equivalent to this is, this is G3 bit, this is G2 bit, this is G1 bit, and this is G0 bit. Okay, so 0010 is equivalent by gray code. So 0011 is here, and its equivalent gray code is 0010. Like this, we will fill this truth table first. So for row number 0, it is 0000 is a gray code. Now for row number 1, it is 0000 0 plus 0 0 0 plus 0 0 0 plus 1 is 1. Here it is 1. Because see, 0, first we write 0 as it is here, then 0 plus 0 is 0, then 0 plus 0 is here, it will come 0. Okay. This bit is 0 and this bit is 1. And then 0 plus 1 is 1. See, because see here, 0, 0, 0, 1. How we will write? Write this 0. Okay, I will write somewhere else, otherwise it will be hidden by the image. Okay. Zero, 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 1. Suppose this is the binary number. 0001. So what we will, how we will write? 0, right, as it is. Then 0 plus 0 is 0, then this 0 plus 0 is 0, then 0 plus 1 is 1, in this way. Then 0010, for this the gray code is 0, 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1. This already we have written. Then 0100, for this 0, then 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, and 0 plus 0 is 0. Then come to fifth row, 0 write as it is, then 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 1 is 1. Row 6th, 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, and 1 plus 0 is 1. Come to row number 7, write MSB bit as it is, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 0, 1 plus 1, 0. Okay. Then row number 8, MSB bit is 1, write as it is, 1 plus 0 is 1, then 0 plus 0 is 0, and 0 plus 0 is 0. Then for row number 9, keep 1 as it is, 1 plus 0, 1, 0 plus 0, 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, this is 1. Then 10th row, 1, MSB bit as it is, 1 plus 0, 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0, 1. Then 11th bit, 11th row, MSP is 1, 1 plus 0, 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 0. Row number 12, MSB bit is 1, then 1 plus 1, 0, 1 plus 0, 1, 0 plus 0, 0. 13th row, MSB bit is 1, 1 plus 1, 0, 1 plus 0, 1, 0 plus 1, 1. Row number 14th, MSB bit is 1, 1 plus 1, 0, 1 plus 1, 0, 1 plus 0, 1. And last row, MSB bit is 1, 1 plus 1, 0, 1 plus 1, 0, 1 plus 1, 0. So this is the truth table, right? This is the truth table of binary, 4-bit binary to gray code converter. Now, what we have to do, we have to find out the logic expression for each bit of gray code, right? So for that, we may use the key map. So I will just show you example of the KMAP of this G0 bit, right? So this is the KMAP for finding out the expression for G0. B3 B2, and here it is B1 and B0. Okay, so this is 00011110 00011110. So we will fill the cells 01 1. Okay, then 0 1 1 0, then 0 1 1 0, 0 1 1 0, 0 1 1 0, 0 1 1 0, then 0 1 1 0, this and this. So we have here one, this is one quad and this is another quad. The solution for these quads are, for this quad the solution is B1 bar B0, and the solution for this quad is B1 B0 bar. So the expression for G0 will be B1 bar B0 plus B1 B0 bar, and this is the XOR of B0 and B1. So this is B1 XOR B0, right? So in this way we have to find out the solution, the logic expression for each bit of gray output number, right? So you do it yourself. And finally, now we will get this expression, right? G0 is equal to B0 XOR B1. g1 is equal to b1 xor b2, g2 is equal to b2 xor b3, and g3 is equal to b3. Now we will write the behavior model for this code, and this is the behavior model. We start with the keyword module, we end with the end module. The name of this Verilog module is binary to gray. The ports are B3, B2, B1, B0, G3, G2, G1, G0, where the input ports are B3, B2, B1, B0. Output ports are G3, G2, G1, G0. And we have declared the output ports as a rig also, rig G3, G2, G1, G0. Then always at the rate, and in the sensitivity list of this always block, we have included all the input signals like B3, B2, B1, B0. Then begin, end. And now directly we will write the expressions. G0 is equal to B1 cap B0. So this cap indicate XOR operation. So B1 XOR B0. According to these expressions, G1 is equal to B2 XOR B1. G2 is equal to B3 XOR B2 and G3 is equal to B3. So here this G we write small G, because we have declared here G3 a small G. G3. So this is the behavior model. Now we will write the data flow model by using assign statement. So simply it is very easy now. So here, up to here, it is exactly same as the behavior model, and here there is no need to declare the G3, G2, G1, G0 as a rig type, because we are not using the always block, we are using assign statement. So assign G0 is equal to B1 XOR B0, assign G1 is equal to B2 XOR B1, assign G2 is equal to B3 XOR B2, and assign G3 is equal to B3, and end module. So in this way, this is a data flow model. Now we want to write the structure model. For structure model, what I will do, first I will draw the gate level diagram of binary to gray converter as per this expression. So here I will draw this. So we need one XOR gate. Its output is G0, and it has two inputs. B0, B1, and the label which I am giving to this XOR gate is X1. Now I need second XOR gate for my second expression G1. So here see the expression G1 is equal to B1 XOR B2. So B1 I will take from here, this is B1, and B2, the second input is B2. Now for third expression, I will, and the label of this XOR gate I am giving X2. Now I will use third XOR gate, which will be used for third expression, that is of G2. So expression for G2 is B2 XOR B3. So B2 I will take from here, and B3 is the second input. So this is B3. Now in the last we have G3 is equal to B3. Then the label of this XOR gate I am giving X3. Now the last expression is G3 is equal to B3. So for that, what I am doing, I am using one buffer, right? Output of this buffer is G3, and input to this buffer is B3. And I will give the label to this buffer as B1. Okay. So this is the structure of this binary to gray converter. So now this is the structure model. We start with the module, we end with the end module. Binary to gray is the name of this module. B2, B3, B2, B1, B0, G3 up to G0, these are the ports, input ports, output ports we have declared. So all these things are exactly same as behavior model and data flow model. Now we are doing the instantiation. Instantiation number 1, 2, 3. So for 4 instantiation statements are required for 4 components. So instantiation statement number 1, XOR, and this is for XNOT gate. Okay, so this gate is basically XNOT. We will give XNOT. And this is X1 and this is X2. And buffer name I have given A1. Okay, so we will take it as A1 in place of B1. The name of this buffer is A1. Okay, so instantiation statement number 1, it is for this XOR gate. So first we will write the output. Output is G0. So here G0, inputs are B0 and B1. Inputs are B0 and B1. Then the second instantiation statement is for X1 XOR gate. It has the output G1. So output is G1. Inputs are B1 and B2. So inputs are B1 and B2. Then the third instantiation statement is for XOR gate labeled as X2. Its output is G2 and inputs are B2 and B3. So G2 is the output, B2 and B3 are the input. Then fourth instantiation statement is for my buffer. Its output is G3 and input is B3. So output is G3, input is B3. So this is the structure module. Okay. So now this is a test bench. The name of the test bench is test bench B3, B2, B1, B0. These are the ports of the test bench which are connected to input ports of unit under test. So exactly same name we have used because the input ports of the unit under test is B3, B2, B1, B0. And here the test bench port which are connected to the input ports should be declared as rig type. So that's why they are rig type. Now output ports of the unit under test are G3, G2, G1, G0. And the test bench ports which are connected to these output ports should be declared as wire. So I am declaring it as a wire, and name I have used same name, G3, wired G2, wired G1, wired G0. And then this statement is the instantiation statement, binary to gray, unit under test. And here these ports, whatever I have mentioned, these are the ports of test bench. And I have used here the positional association. What are the positions of my unit under test port? Exactly same way they are, the test bench port are interfaced. For example, the test bench port B3 is at first position. So what is the position of unit under test first port? It is B3. So B3 is interfaced with B3. The next test bench port is B2, is interfaced with the next port of unit under test B2. So in the same sequence, what is the sequence here given, and whatever sequence are given here, so they are interfaced in the same sequence. Okay. And remaining thing is already we have done, we have discussed so many times regarding these test bench. So these are the stimulus. According to these stimulus, some gray outputs will be generated. So now I will just demonstrate to this particular behavior model and the test bench. So same test bench can be used for any or these three type of modeling, right? Oh, okay. Where it is, right? So here you can find this is the unit under test, that is the behavior model of my binary to gray converter, right? So same thing we have discussed, same model I have taken here. Now this is the test bench, whatever just now we have discussed, the same test bench is here, right? Now I will simulate this test bench. Okay, so here we will see, so see the signals, first signal is G3, then G2, then G1, then G0, and then B3, B2, B1, B0. So we will test this condition. Here the binary inputs are 0, see B3 is 0, B2 is 0, B1 is 0, and B3, B2. Okay, here it has in B3, B2, B1, B0. B3, B2, B1, B0. Okay, and here B3, B2, B1, B0. B2, B1, B0. But in the test bench, it is coming differently. I will just check here why it is coming in different sequence. The unit under test, B3, B2, B1, B0, G3, G2, G1, G0, B2, B1, B3, B2, B1, B0, G3. Okay, then test bench we will see. B3, B2, B1, B0, G3, G2, G1, G0. And here B3, B2, B1, B0, G3, G2, G1, G0. B3, B2, B1, B0, G3, G2, G1, G0. Then B3, B2, B1, B0. B3, B2. It should come in that way only. I will see you once again. Yes, now it is okay. Right. So inputs, binary inputs are 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. B3 is 0, B2 is 0, B1 is 0, and B0 is 1. So you can compare in the truth table this 0, 0, 0, 1. For this case, the gray output will be 0, 0, 0, 1. It should be this 0, 0, 0, 1. So we check this result. So G3 is 0, G2 is 0, G1 is 0, and G0 is 1. Okay, this is okay. Now we check another condition. B3 is 0, B2 is 1. Then B1 is 0, B0 is 1. 0, 1, 0, 1. So for this case, 0, 1, 0, 1 here. So gray outputs will be 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 1, 1. 0, 1, 1. So gray outputs will be 0, 1, 1, 1. So you check here, G3 is 0, then G2 is 1, G1 is 1, G0 is 1. We check some other condition, B3 is 1, B2 is 0, B1 is 0, B0 is 1. So 1, 0, 0, 1 for this, 1, 0, 0, 1 here. The gray output will be 1, 1, 0, 1. Gray output will be 1, 1, 0, 1. We check here, G3 is 1, G2 is 1, G1 is 0, G0 is 1. So 1, 1, 0, 1. This is also okay. We check another condition. Now binary inputs are 0, 0, 1, 1. 0, 0, 1, 1. 0, 0, 1 for this. What is the gray output? 0, 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 0. This is the gray output. 0, 0, 1, 0. We check the result. 0, 0, 1, 0. See here, G3 is 0, G2 is 0, G1 is 1, G0 is 1. So this code is perfectly working as 4-bit binary to gray code converter. So in this way, now you can try to write the code for 4-bit gray to binary converter, right? You follow the same methodology and you try to write the code for 4-bit gray to binary converter. Okay.